ladies and gentlemen, for the hundreds that are listening and the thousands in attendance, welcome to Monday Night Live. Welcome to the Hate Train Show.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Oh, now you're going to listen to the show.
Abba-dabba-doo!
Oh, that's right!
I am skinny, dang it!
Dinosaurs are real.
Still, can still serve a purpose.
I'll be right back.
Don't you go dying on me!
Welcome, you got... yeah, okay, he's good.
What the heck was that?
Hey,
yeah, baby.
There we go. All right. If I don't officially say it, if I just go, he'll at least think about, okay.
I start panicking. I know I need to do something good.
What do I need to do? Right. That way I'm not, like, you know, picking at the mouse and stuff.
Just make pig noises.
He's learning.
Hee-haw, and I know exactly what it means.
He's learning.
He is learning. And he's actually doing a really good job.
He is. He very much is. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a fantastic show for you playing today.
We do.
It's going to be fine. Don't get your hopes up, people.
Fantastic is a strong word.
Hey.
We have an adequate
show. Hey, if you're
planned.
A Bronco fan, everything's looking up.
Yes, sir, it is. Dude, it is.
Wow.
Is Eric on here right now?
Yeah. Wow. What a – so, first of all, how was your weekend?
Oh, it was great. It was super. What I was getting ready to say is real quick. You're listening to the show that highlights all the nonprofit programs out there beyond the VA. You're listening to the H Train Show. We are broadcasting from Colorado Media School here in the Bellefonte area. With me today is my colleague, my co-host, the Mouth,
not
Rob.
From the South.
And then on the keys, he's been doing a great job. Hold up, I gotta turn this camera, because
I was wondering what was it's like angled like this.
I felt like I was on a movie of Alien or something.
Yeah, I gotta redo all those camera angles on that thing.
Intern, you're on your own for the first time tonight.
Yeah,
are you feeling a little nervous? You okay?
No, I got it down.
But you do. I'm impressed. I'm excited for you.
No,
okay.
I got it down.
Wow, that just made it worse.
No, we're good. Right. I just got to adjust it from there.
Okay,
all right.
Okay, so.
great view of my sneakers for a minute.
On the pie, on the keys, we got Johnny Mike.
Hi.
And before we go too much into the show, everybody, thank you for riding with us. Oh, got it. All right, so
you know, I can push a button or two if that would help you.
Yeah, I know, right?
Because it feels like you're getting your ass kicked.
He's getting an 8 mile walk, but it's just
so,
in the studio.
Check this out. I was humbled today.
Doesn't take much for me, so
I'm gonna read this.
I saw that you sent that, but I didn't know what it meant.
We maybe we won't read this. I'm gonna
say,
here, I was trying to like magnify and everything. It was a text, but anyways, Johnny Mike, his mother, and one of his doctors, they pitched in and they donated $100
really
to MBR, and it was nice. The letter basically said,
if you want,
huh?
You want me to read it?
You can.
I can try.
Go ahead.
So they wrote in cursive, which you and I understand.
Right.
But like, if I handed this to my kid, they'd be like, what is this?
What is this Egyptian word?
Yeah, exactly. All right, let's see what it says here, if I can do this. It says, Dear Joel, And that's all I got, man. I can't go any further.
No, what it said, dear Joel, I just wanted to thank you for your passion and dedication. You and Rob making the lives of veterans much better.
Huh?
And please accept this donation to MBR because yada yada. I
can read the handwriting.
Can you? Is that mom's handwriting? Yeah, is that what it is?
Oh, I can read it.
We may need to present you the original later for you to read.
Gosh, man, I think we lost listeners because that was terrible trying to listen to me read.
We should
post
the picture and see what and let people interpret it themselves.
Try to read the cursive. Yeah. Like, wait, is this an S? Is this a J? I can't really tell.
Does your mom listen to the show?
Sometimes, yeah. She's in Florida right now, so it's a little too late. So I doubt she's listening right now.
I feel like we could have some fun with this information.
Yeah. Well, listen, we just wanted to let you guys know. Thank you so much. For that, and
yeah, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah,
especially
it really is.
So, for those that don't know, so this is a 501c3 established by him. This is a not for profit, so we survive entirely on donations.
Right.
So, you know, when people like the Flight Medic Club donated that knife, and all of our corporate sponsors like Girding Enterprises, and do we still have the golf? Is that still?
We're still working it. We don't have it.
Sawaya Law Firm. Who else we got? We Colorado Moto Service sponsors us.
Combat
Flip Flops. They have we have a partnership with them, so that's kind of a different thing. But we still. I don't know if you saw that email from Griff.
I did.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for an email from our really good friends at Boston Scally. I'm waiting to hear from them.
Working on it. We'll get there.
Oh, I know. I know.
They're busy. They're very busy.
They do a lot for us, and
it was great being at the. Oh, yeah. Who was at that game?
Oh,
that's awesome. That's got
as a Broncos fan or as a Cowboys fan.
He's a
die hard Broncos fan.
Oh, okay, okay.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
he was one of thousands of Broncos fans. Because if you saw the pictures of the game.
I didn't.
Sea of orange.
Really?
It was in Dallas, and it looked like half the stadium was Broncos fans because the orange just. It stands out so well.
And I don't know much about the NFL lately. I haven't been following, but I thought I thought the Cowboys were doing really well.
They were until they played us.
And to the kneecaps?
It was crazy.
Right now, the Cowboys are predicted to win the Super Bowl after yesterday.
Yep.
I don't know if that's going to happen, but you know, I know that we don't really talk sports because that's Swish's show. But I will say this. The one thing, we went to bed 4-4. We woke up, Miller, 5-4, not 7-2. Ow!
Yep.
But things are looking up for the Broncos.
You like go to practices and stuff like that, don't you? You're that guy.
Sometimes.
Take Barrett with you and, hey, you look good. You want to sign this?
Sometimes I just go to, learn and stuff whenever. DMAC lets me tag along.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Very cool. I mean, that's an opportunity not a lot of people get. So that's
I know.
When I was in recruiting, my friends from 160th came into town. And so I reached out to the Broncos and they arranged for them to get a tour of the facility. And they got their picture taken on the field and stuff like that and gave a flag to the Broncos and all that cool stuff. So I've seen the inside of the facility, but you know, I wouldn't recognize any of these guys if I tripped over them. Peyton Manning, that's about it. And you got me that ball, which I really, really appreciate.
Yeah. Well, if they allow us to come back this next year, because I guess COVID was a big reason why they didn't allow. But once they allow us to bring veterans back, you know, me and Brandon will be taking 12 veterans. Every time
the guy that does the tours is awesome. He's super, a really nice guy. He let those guys wander all over that place. It was kind of funny. What's Veterans Day look like for you? What are you doing?
Oh my gosh. I'm packed busy. I leave Wednesday for Boston.
Oh, I forgot. That's right. Yes. You're going to go hang out with Allie.
I'm trying my Boston.
I keep forgetting.
I'm trying my Boston accent.
Patriots 1-2.
So she's on the show and she listens to the show.
Yeah.
That poor woman.
I know, right?
Good Lord, the poor girl.
Oh, I'm so excited. But I'm gonna be going to Boston. I don't wanna try to say it in the accent, you know.
You should stop.
Well, dude, it's hilarious. It like triggers people.
It does.
Like, what you know me, I'm not political.
What happens if you trip
all
over Marky Mark and you try to talk to him?
But
or Ben Affleck.
I'm not political at all. And I know that I get some feedback, but I get more laughs than feedback. I go on the 8th show on like 9 News or whatever. It doesn't matter what they're posting. I put, let's go, Brandon.
You're really poking the bear, huh?
Dude, I get like 200,000 views and stuff of it. It's awesome.
I'm getting text messages as we're broadcasting for people.
But. Yeah, so I get to go to Boston, and then
I'm gonna be
speaking there from the 10th to the 12th.
Where are you talking? Where are you speaking?
I'm sure Allie will.
You
like
have no idea. That's awesome. I have no clue.
I go where Allie tells me to go.
I love it, dude. That's my favorite thing.
Well, I know that we're not just doing one. We're doing like 2 or 3 schools.
Oh, like elementary schools or what?
I believe so.
Oh, very cool.
I believe so. Because she came, she called me, and she's like, hey, can we fit this other school in? Yeah, but if we do it, like, we can't taste. We just eat.
That's,
you know? And I'm like, okay, I'm good.
Oh, so you're going for like a lunch or something like that?
Maybe. But you know me, dude. I'll eat at like 2 or 3. Missing breakfast and lunch doesn't really bother me.
Have you been to the East Coast before, like to the New England?
I've been to Waterville, New Hampshire. I've been to Vermont.
Okay.
She tells me that that's not really Boston, but it is Boston.
No, New England is like 7 states, brother.
Okay. All right. Well, then
it's not.
It won't be Boston the first thing I got something wrong.
So Boston is one of our all-time favorite cities. We're from, you know, our family's from Connecticut. So Boston, he's speaking at a porn store. Yeah, absolutely he is. That's so awesome. Oh my gosh. That's going to be awesome. Row of dildos behind him as he's talking.
Know,
that's good stuff.
You know, he's just going to keep finding sound bits and send it to our intro. Because like I sent all the everything that we need to do for our intro. Mm-hmm. I sent it to the guy and he comes back and he's like, man, this is a lot to put in to a 1-minute video. He's like, wow.
So what are you talking about? Are you just like telling your story, talking about NBR? What's your plan?
Oh, no. For the video intro, the H-Train show, there's just only a couple of things that's just going
to
change.
When you go to Boston, what are you talking about?
Oh, when I go to Boston, I'm going to be talking about how to embrace the adaptive spirit. That's what I talk with, like, the older adults. And if they're, like, really young, then I give them kind of a lecture about, you know, not bullying. You know, because when you look at me,
I'm glad I'm not coming with you. All I do is bully you. Holy shit, I'm glad. That would be terrible if I went with you. Tripping you down flights of stairs.
Adult store of 44 already booked.
That's right. There you go, Allie. That is so awesome, dude. Good. I'm excited for you. That's really good stuff. That's
and then
stuff.
When I come back, unfortunately, I guess you'll be hunting because you told me you wasn't going to be able
to be available.
But then when we get back that Sunday, then I go to the Broncos and the Eagles game.
Cool. Very cool.
And that's when they're going to recognize me, Pipes, and then
excellent
Willie.
So I was supposed to be hunting, but I don't know if you saw on Facebook, I got my deer Friday night, first day.
I did. I saw that.
Yeah. So here's the part of that that sucks. Yeah, exactly. So you shoot your deer on opening day.
How are we on time?
Yeah, we got a minute left.
Okay.
You shoot your deer on opening day. The problem is you come home that night and your wife's like, oh, how was hunting tonight? Oh, I got a deer. You know, it's in the back of the truck. Life is good. Oh. So you'll be home this weekend? Oh, crap. Yes. She's like, great. We've got a ton of stuff we need to get done around the house. Uh-oh. So, yeah. Apparently, I'm choring this past weekend and this weekend. And I did this past weekend. Yeah.
But that's great that you got the deer.
Yeah.
That's super awesome.
Well, the part about hunting I like is sitting out in the woods with my friends, which is also cool. But okay. Deer, yes, deer is delicious. So, yeah, I picked that up. There it is. Uh-oh. You all right? Good guy. I know.
We'll be back. Technical difficulties. Yeah,
exactly.
You're listening to the show that highlights all the
non-profit
programs out there beyond the VA. You're listening to the H-Train Show.
Do you need assistance? When the truth is found
to be. I'm attorney Diane Sawaya. COVID may be affecting our everyday lives, but we're still here to fight for you. We may use technology to get the care you need, and we can handle your paperwork electronically. But there's one thing that hasn't changed. We still won't back down. We'll get the results you deserve, safely.
Diane Sawaya. Smart. Aggressive. Compassionate. Call 303-758-4777.
Military Broadcast Radio Network. My name is Dominic Lawson, and I am the host of The Startup Life, the show for entrepreneurs and career-minded professionals. And we are so glad and so eager to bring The Startup Life to the Military Broadcast Radio Network. Now, you may be wondering, who the hell am I? What the hell is The Startup Life? I'm glad you asked. So, first me. I'm an Army vet for 5 years, and while I was in the service, I had all these ideas for starting a company and stuff like that. But I wasn't sure what to do about that. So when I got out of the service, I was like, you know what? Maybe I'm not ready just yet. But so I went back to work. The thing is about when you have that entrepreneurial mindset, those ideas just never go away. So I talked to my wife, and coming to find out, she had the same idea about starting a company. So we talked about it, and we started a company. We started Owls LLC, an education consulting firm, where we write curriculum and do professional development with teachers, school districts, nonprofits, and things of that nature. And then from there, I started like noticing all of these different business philosophies, the way a school does has its business model, another business have their business model. And I started writing this blog. And the thing is about that blog is that, you know, it was taking a lot of time. So my wife, being the smarter half of us, said, you know what, you should start a podcast. So in November 1st of 2016, that's exactly what we did. We started The Startup Life. And so that was 3.5 years ago. And now we've grown the show to over 160 episodes. Now, what you get from The Startup Life is we bring in the best business minds from around the world. We're talking Mark Randolph, the co-founder and first CEO of Netflix. We're talking about Tom Golisano, the founder and chairman of Paychex. We're even talking about the chairman of JetBlue Airways and Stanford business professor, Joel Peterson. And so we bring all of these great business minds and we bring them to you, MBR. So that way you can scale your entrepreneurial mindset. You can scale your leadership acumen, whether you're still in the service or you're about to become a veteran and start that path of civilian life. So if you're ready to upgrade your entrepreneurial mindset and you're ready to just totally just level up, join me every Wednesday at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Military Broadcast Radio Network. Let's go.
Hey, it's Rob with the Colorado State leader for Mission 22, practicing social distancing today out on the road. I understand for a lot of us that with no gym being open, no jiu-jitsu going on, I know it's a challenging time right now for a lot of folks. You're looking for that community. You're looking for something. Reach out. You know the number, 303-301-5052. You can call that number anytime. I will answer. I know a lot of people are having a hard time. Reach out to your friends. Don't wait till you're in that dark place. Don't wait till you're in that pit. Before you get down there, reach out to your friends. Say, hey, let's talk. Let's go have some social distancing together. Cool? Hey, again, reach out to Mission22.com.
I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. It feel like my life ain't mine. I've been on the low, I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. It feel like my life ain't mine. I don't wanna be alive. I think they know it. I've been praying for somebody to save me. No one's heroic in my life. Don't even matter. I know it. I know it. I know I'm hurt deep down, but can't show it. I never had a place to call my own.
Oh, why hello there. Today, I'm going to show you how to make one of my new favorite drinks, whiskey and spray. And today, I'm feeling a little different today. So we're going to do some proper 12 Irish whiskey.
Next, got to grab the mixer. Today we're going to use Sprite.
Also, can't forget the whiskey glass. Now that you have pretty much everything you need, can't forget the ice. So, a little ice in the cup. Take your whiskey, pop the top, do a generous pour, and then simply add the spray. And now, cheers to yourself, enjoy the rest of your day. And that's how I make a whiskey and spray. Refreshing.
Yeah, there we go.
Even though Pipes is not with us, he's still here in voice.
We're back. You're listening to the show that highlights all the nonprofit programs out there beyond the VA. You're listening to the AIDS Train Show. And I was going to tell you, Rob, he created this really professional, great letter. And we've been sending it out to one, you know, to our guests to invite them onto the show. And the reason why I'm telling you this is because we would love, if you know somebody that's inspiring, if you know somebody that, you know, speaks, that wants to tell their story, or, you know, a motivational speaker, have them reach out to us, manager@mbradio.us. We would love to have them, because we're getting ready to start a new season, and our focus, you know, it was nonprofits, and then we focus more on the veteran-owned veteran businesses, and I just thought it'd be a nice change to focus on, you know, inspirational speakers, because, you know, like me and you talked when we had John Register on.
That was a very popular
interview.
And even people in the studio were like, whoa.
Right. Yeah, you know, he just made you want to see. I did a little bit of thinking, Rob, but
that's a dangerous, dangerous
thing. I know, right?
Did anyone authorize that tree for you?
I know. I know. But the thing is Monday, if you have something like that, like inspiring, that's like motivation, I want this show to be electrifying. Because I think if you have something to look forward to, electrifying event, it gives you hope and it helps you through the week.
I see a lot of people that really that don't enjoy Mondays, that people bellyache about Mondays. Oh, it's Monday. Oh, the weekend's over. Monday's my favorite day of the week. I love coming here and getting the chance to talk to the veteran community and put out the good things that we got going on and that is going on in the veteran community. Monday is by far my favorite day of the week, by far.
Yeah, I just...
The only problem is the schedule is packed and I don't get to go to the gym and I'm going to go to jiu-jitsu. So, yeah. But other than that, I do love... I don't get to do anything on Mondays. I wake up, work, and then come right here.
Well, I would love to say that this is the reason why we named the show the Ace Train Show, but I can't say this because I just found the poem, the passage. I just found it yesterday. And I had posted it on the show page. Basically, an ace train, a train is like life, and it talks about making stops, but looking through the journey. I have it screenshotted. But that's one of the things that I posted yesterday.
Okay,
and
you're not following us on social media, please feel free to. We're on Instagram, we're on TikTok, we're on Facebook, we're on all of them. I know we're on Twitter. I know we're not that active on Twitter, but we are on Twitter as well.
Twitter is at H Train Show.
I think it's Hunt for
Train
Gold.
Show.
Oh, is it?
It's H-Train Show. H-Train Show.
Oh.
Everything's H Train Show.
I've been tagging you wrong then.
Yeah, that's okay.
So what is Hunt for Gold? That's what came up.
Hunt for Gold is, it was my page when I was skiing competitively.
Whoops.
Yeah, that's okay.
You got a lot of tags on there that don't belong there.
Yeah.
My bad, it's dog. Okay. I didn't know that.
Hey, it's okay. You're gonna reach me somehow, some way. I don't care if I have a lot of followers or not, or a lot of friends on there. It's just one of those social media platforms that I'm like posting information. Dude, I'm hardly ever on Facebook anymore. Like, I'll post, but I'm always on TikTok. Why? TikTok is just... It's more entertaining and it's more motivating than Facebook. It really is.
You're on it for the chicks and bikinis. I'm down. I get it, dude. I'm a huge fan.
Right?
I'm a huge fan. I agree, though. I'm looking forward to January of 2022. We've already got a couple of motivational speakers booked. Nick Scarabosio, you and I know through jiu-jitsu. Who is a kind of a business coach, a motivational speaker kind of thing.
Right.
We have him January 3rd, I want to say. And I know we have Anthony Dries coming up. Have you ever met Anthony?
I have.
Tony? So, dude is cool like the other side of the pillow. I love that guy. I've met him a bunch of times through iHeart. He's just super cool. And I bumped into him at the airport 2 weeks ago when I was coming back from Texas. On the train. And I was like, oh, how perfect is that timing? And so he'll be on the show. He's a Purple Heart recipient. I believe he's missing a leg. Might be two, but I know he's missing at least one. And yeah, he'll be on the show middle of January. I forget what the date is off the top of my head, but he's got an awesome story.
Oh, it looks like we have a Google Voice.
We do?
We haven't even gotten into the what the segment.
That's, we're not ringing.
Oh. No, never mind. That wasn't Google Voice. That was my phone. Somebody's trying to call me while I'm on the air.
Okay.
Anyways, okay, ladies and gentlemen, we better hit it before we lose it. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the What The segment.
They're cool tats, man.
Oh, for real. Thank you, bro. You see the cobra?
Yeah, what is this one?
Oh, this? Uh-huh. That's my credo. No regrets.
Mm-hmm. You have no regrets?
Dad?
No.
Like, not even a single letter?
No way. Not me.
Well, I love him. I think he's great.
Okay.
I think he's a real winner, Casey. If I were you, I wouldn't use protection.
What the?
I love that intro.
I do. And that's I think that might be the biggest reason why we're keeping that segment.
I agree completely. I can't wait to get the letter from Jennifer, what's her name's lawyers that say cease and desist. I'm really looking forward to those.
Right?
So because we can call Max and be like, dude, what's up with your wife?
Right. Oh yeah, we got some comments.
I'll bet
we should probably read those out,
or maybe we shouldn't, in a different case, based on some of them.
But while he's doing that, we're gonna bring up the Facebook page, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna share the screen.
We are.
Yep.
We.
And you will go right to the Facebook, right to the Messenger. Just go up there.
And turn this is fun to watch you do, brother.
And then bam. And then bam.
What is that?
There we go.
Ram. What does that say? Rams.
Rams Titan fight ends. We're gonna watch some video.
We are on the radio.
Well, we're gonna try. I don't know. Let's see.
Yay! Oh heck yeah!
Oh!
Was not ready. Oh!
Oh, he just stepped on his head.
Did that dude just knock out those two dudes?
Yeah.
That was better than UFC on Saturday night.
All right, so.
Dude!
The reason why we're bringing this article up, let's talk about it.
Article?
That was
a video of a couple of Bubbas getting their dick knocked in the dirt.
I don't know how you messed it up. They're saying that it didn't even show it.
Look, man, we're working with an intern here. What are you doing?
Oh, it's because
quit giving the guy a hard time.
It opened in a new tab.
Whatever. Long story short, two dudes got knocked out hard.
Yeah, really hard.
So why are you wanting to talk about this?
Because
I thought you were a pacifist. I thought you didn't like to fight.
No.
Here, let's play it again for the audience.
The reason why I wanted to bring this up, or is it going to play it this again? Time?
Yay! They're not serious. Yay! That dude is still baby.
So the reason why I'm bringing this up is because. The reason why I'm bringing this up is because there was something that happened yesterday.
There was.
The Travis Scott concert.
That was Friday night, but yeah.
Friday night.
Yeah.
They had 8 people die.
My son has been.
A bunch of injured.
Has been bringing this up. Like, he's been very vocal about this. I don't even know who Travis Scott is, dude. I assume it's not a country singer. It's a rap singer, from what I understand.
The reason why I'm bringing this up is there's a lot of violence with people going back into the public. And the reason why I wanted to talk about that is because I think what we're seeing right now.
That dude took a nap on the stairs. Not a great idea.
I think what we're seeing right now is basically what soldiers go through when they come back from Iraq. They come back from Iraq. They get back trying to transition. And then they kind of explode. And I think with the civilian... I'm just bringing that up because with the civilian side of it, you know, they've dealt with COVID. And now since they've released everybody, I mean, now I don't want to call it PTS or anything, but, you know, the attitude and stuff, I think it's from being cooped up and then like released out. You know, I think that's what's going on with a lot of the trauma and everything in the league, because that's not the first NFL fight that's happened this week.
So the Travis Scott thing, that wasn't violence, wasn't that just a matter of
bad
like
security?
I thought it was just like a fan rushing the stage.
Yeah, exactly. So bad security, if you ask me. But like there was too many people, ooh, and they were all trying to get to the front. A 50,000 person festival, and everybody was trying to scoot to the front, and apparently they knocked over some barriers so that way they could rush to the front, and people got crushed under it. So people were getting crushed because it was just overpacked and overcrowded. And so they were literally getting trampled and like suffocating underneath people.
Intern, how old are you?
29.
29. So you're a little younger. I'm 47 and you're similar age.
Right.
We grew up on festivals like Lollapalooza.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Like when Lollapalooza was like 16 bands and it was like a day long.
Yeah.
Lollapalooza number two. I'm at Lollapalooza. I take this girl, Kim, to Lollapalooza. Okay. It was at a Rhode Island airport. Rage Against the Machine is the opening act. She's like, I want to get there early and I want to get to the front of the stage. I'm like, you absolutely do not want that. And she's like, no, this is happening. So we left like early in the morning. We got to Rhode Island. We get to there. We get push all the way through the crowd. We get to the plywood and we're leaning on the plywood like an hour before the show starts. Rage Against the Machine walks out on stage, not playing any music or anything. I don't know if you know who, obviously know who Rage Against the Machine is. Exactly. And so they get ready to get start playing and they start playing music and the crowd just erupts. And I mean, that's the only word you can use is erupts.
Okay.
This girl is screaming at the top of her lungs. She's like, get me out of here. So I grab her by the hand and I just go straight through the center of the mosh pit. Right. Cut right
to the
through.
Back.
Yep. Right through the center of the thing. And I got my head up and I got her by the hand and I'm like sprinting through the mosh pit and I see a boot coming right for my head. And somebody's like flying through the air. I duck. She didn't see it. Bam! Oh. And it hits her right square in the face and knocks her down in the middle of the mosh pit. So now I pick her up and her face is bleeding and whatnot. And we are sprinting across trying to get out of that mosh pit. It was awesome.
Man.
Yeah, but that's expected. That was part of the show. Nowadays, like I keep hearing more and more about these fans rushing stages and breaking down things and whatnot. And it cost eight people their lives. And from what I understand,
hundreds in the hospital.
Hundreds injured. Yeah. I want to fight a Cowboys fan Sunday. Oh, I wanted to. People get too comfortable talking shit to the computer and not being smacked. And that's exactly where I was going with this, Reed. You got the wrong guy. You're a pacifist. I am an advocate for violence. I think it solves a lot of problems. Like our listener is saying, people have gotten comfortable with saying things that should not be said to people's faces. And we see images of it. You see people like screaming in the faces of police officers and these protests. And you see people screaming at the whole, some of the protests that we had here in Denver, people just losing their minds.
Screaming
at
waiters and airport security and everything.
Yeah. And you're like, hey man, this person needs to have their dick knocked in the dirt. It has not happened. This person, if you haven't been in a fight once in your life, I don't trust you as much. If you've been punched in the face before, you know it sucks.
Right.
And well, I mean, you did combatives and all that stuff when you were in the army. Stuff like, so you've been punched in the face once or twice.
Oh, yeah.
So if, you know, if Bernie is saying something to you, you're probably going to keep your mouth shut. A guy that size says something, maybe I'll be a little more quiet this time. But, you know, yeah, people have just lost the ability to sometimes you need to keep your opinion to yourself and your mouth shut. I'd love to see the rest of that video, what led up to it.
Right.
Because that dude was throwing haymakers,
man. Yeah, you
man.
Only see the aftermath. This is with anything and everything.
Agreed.
You always see the aftermath, but you don't see, like, the beginning, you know? Because remember, it takes the average person 15 seconds to pull up the video camera. So everything that happened within those 15 seconds, how did it happen?
Well, and that's that. You're bringing up another good point. When you and I were growing up, there was not cell phones. We didn't have that.
Right.
So there was no risk of you and I getting into a fight and somebody taping it. Nowadays, when violence erupts, rather than stepping in and stopping it, and that's the other thing too, is that you had friends that would grab you and be like, "Hey, man, that dude's gonna kick your ass. You probably should." People don't do that anymore. Like we have a listener right there, Roy. Roy. And the Meadows was fun too, throwing clumps of grass, tearing down the fence, burning it in multiple locations. And he and I could go on and on for hours about stuff like this because he and I used to work at concerts. And actually, well, anyway, most violent concert I've ever been to, Jimmy Buffett.
Oh, okay.
30 people to the hospital. Yeah.
I saw him on Labor Day. It was the least violent concert I had ever been to.
Absolutely amazing.
They had a guy on the train the other day. I think it's been like 3 or 4 weeks. He raped a woman, and everybody was watching videotaping
it.
Yeah.
And that's the difference. Yeah. That was what, Philadelphia or something like that? That woman got raped, literally raped on the train, and people watched it and videotaped it rather than stepping in and doing something about it.
Yeah.
And that's a whole different. I'm not an advocate for
We saw that the shooting at King Soopers. Like, literally, they had a YouTube. This guy, he was hearing shots inside the grocery store.
Oh, the one in Boulder we talked about a few months ago?
He was videoing. I think I should get out of here. Should I taxi? I mean, he's like talking about it in the YouTube, and I'm like, dude,
yeah. If someone's shooting at you, the cell phone is not what you need to be pulling out.
Exactly.
Man. Well, and yeah, but what I'm not an advocate for is you're hearing more and more of people getting violent with like flight attendants.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, hey, man. And again, these are the people that probably did not get punched in the face as they were growing up. Exactly. If you're talking to, and I don't know if the flight attendants were male or female or whatever, or whatever the case may be. But if you're talking to someone like that, and you're, that is not the place for it. That is not where you need to be swinging for the fences. Not an incident like that.
Right.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. Yeah, that's rough.
And I think
I'd love to know what the rest of that story was.
I do too. And
I'll bet it was stupid.
You know,
exactly.
Well, I mean,
it was a football game. It had to have been.
Yeah, I mean, about somebody got a Diet Coke instead of a Coke.
Exactly.
Well, that's exactly what we're talking about. Like, you know, people like going to McDonald's and whatnot, and like jump in the counter at McDonald's because, you know, they didn't get enough Oreos in their McFlurry. Is that a thing? I don't know.
Dude, I'd be pretty mad too.
Hey, I told Johnny Mike before the show, there are a lot of fights, and including the Raiders, because the Raiders haven't won a playoff game since Facebook.
The Raiders and Reed can come back with it. Weren't the Raiders legendary for? I mean, they were in Oakland.
Oh yeah.
So yeah,
they were big in when
with violence
when Madden was coach.
Oh, I don't. Oh yeah.
Oh, I think if I'm not mistaken, I think they won. There was like a dynasty of like 10 years, from like 70 to 80s. It was pure Raiders.
But I mean, fans fighting and stuff in the parking lot.
Oh,
and whatnot.
Yeah.
I think it's gotten worse.
Well, and the Broncos, our team, used to be legendary for not having fights and stuff like that in the parking lot. And then that has changed now. Now there are fights in the parking lots and people getting pushed down the stairs and people falling off the edges. What's up?
We're just running low on time is all.
Oh,
okay.
Sorry.
It's that time.
Yeah.
All right. Well, hey, thanks for listening, everybody. Okay. We're going to hit a music break. When we come back.
I love Reed's comment.
I like that too.
He means it. I've been hit by him.
You're listening to the show that highlights all the nonprofit programs out there beyond the VA. You're listening to the H Train Show.
It doesn't hurt when he hits.
Military Broadcast Radio Network. My name is Dominic Lawson, and I am the host of The Startup Life, the show for entrepreneurs and career-minded professionals. And we are so glad and so eager to bring The Startup Life to the Military Broadcast Radio Network. Now, you may be wondering, who the hell am I? What the hell is The Startup Life? I'm glad you asked. So, first me, I'm an Army vet for 5 years. And while I was in the service, I had all these ideas for starting a company and stuff like that. But I wasn't sure what to do about that. So when I got out of the service, I was like, you know what? Maybe I'm not ready just yet. But so I went back to work. The thing is about when you have that entrepreneurial mindset, those ideas just never go away. So I talked to my wife, and coming to find out, she had the same idea about starting a company. So we talked about it, and we started a company. We started Owls LLC, an education consulting firm, where we write curriculum and do professional development with teachers, school districts, nonprofits, and things of that nature. And then from there, I started like noticing all of these different business philosophies, the way a school does has its business model, another business have their business model, and I started writing this blog. And the thing is about that blog is that, you know, it was taking a lot of time. So my wife, being the smarter half of us, said, you know what, you should start a podcast. So in November 1st of 2016, that's exactly what we did. We started the Startup Life. And so that was 3.5 years ago. And now we've grown the show to over 160 episodes. Now, what you get from the Startup Life is we bring in the best business minds from around the world. We're talking Mark Randolph, the co-founder and first CEO of Netflix. We're talking about Tom Golisano, the founder and chairman of Paychex. We're even talking about the chairman of JetBlue Airways and Stanford business professor, Joel Peterson. And so we bring all of these great business minds and we bring them to you, MBR. So that way you can scale your entrepreneurial mindset. You can scale your leadership acumen, whether you're still in the service or you're about to become a veteran and start that path of civilian life. So if you're ready to upgrade your entrepreneurial mindset and you're ready to just totally just level up, join me every Wednesday at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Military Broadcast Radio Network. Let's go.
Up for the Troops is a national nonprofit organization who uses the game of golf to help veterans as they transition from the battlefield to the home front. Our mission at Tee It Up for the Troops is to honor, remember, respect, and support all those who have served in the armed forces for the United States of America. Whether they've been injured or they're suffering from some of the invisible wounds of war, we want them to know that we stand ready to help them as they take that next step in life.
You know, I have focused more after being on a golf course. I'm generally happier. And I owe it all actually to this organization. I mean, I really wouldn't be where I'm at physically and mentally and quite frankly emotionally if it hadn't been for meeting and getting to know people in this organization.
As these military men and women return to their communities, we want them to know that there are great organizations out there to help them make that transition. And with our many connections to veteran service organizations around the country, we can make a positive difference for America's veterans and our military families. Teed Up for the Troops looks to support our veterans and military families through 6 key areas of support: suicide prevention, PTSD and traumatic brain injury treatments, employment and career pathing, sports and golf rehabilitation, housing and homelessness, and family and caregiver support. With your help and our many connections to veteran service organizations across the country, we can make a positive difference in the lives of these American veterans.
Common Ground Golf Course looks like a postcard. The USGA thought so much of this championship layout, they made it the companion course for the 2012 US Amateur. Last fall, Common Ground was the victim of Mother Nature and the floods that devastated Aurora. Today, it reopened to the public. One of the best deals in Colorado is back in play.
Just the fact that we're back out here and able to play the full course today is amazing.
Dave Troyer has a bounce in his step. He's the director of golf at Common Ground Golf Course. 8.5 months ago, you needed a boat to navigate some of its fairways.
For 3.5 weeks, we had 6 to 8 feet of water on half the golf course, and it was a devastating blow to everything that we built over the last 5 years here.
September's floods gave new meaning to the term water hazard.
Once it drained off, everything was dead. We had to go through the whole process of regrassing everything down there. You know, we resodded 5 greens, reseeded six and a half fairways.
In the golf business, that's tough to swing.
Being closed, you know, the hard costs and the lost revenue over the time, it was over $1 million hit for us.
Golfers were forced to make do on a modified 9-hole layout. But there's good news. The grass is finally greener on the other side.
Going from water to brown, dead grass to what you see today in such a short time is amazing. Now that we're going to get some 80-degree weather, it'll just explode. And as you can see, it's looks like it's in phenomenal condition already. So we're ready to go.
The comeback is nearly complete.
We're going to play winter rules on these for the first month, 6 weeks. We'll see what it takes. I would say it would be middle end of the summer before it matches the conditions of the rest of the course. Can't beat the tees and can't beat the greens, and you can always find a good lie in the fairway.
One of Common Ground's missions is to give a championship experience at an affordable price. If you're a golfer, you need to check it out. Thank you to Dave, Andy, and Arthur for letting
Project Sanctuary helps reconnect military families so our nation's heroes can finally come home. Find out how you can help at projectsanctuary.us.
This has been the best week of my entire life.
This organization is absolutely fantastic.
I was just blown away.
Incredible time with awesome brothers. I really had no idea how much this was going to do for me.
I'm happy. It's been just a blessing.
These last few days have been awesome, sharing my story and riding with people who still care.
What a great opportunity to be here with your brothers and connect, talking to each other about shared experiences and getting able to sort of unload in a group of people that you're immediately comfortable with.
Some of our problems are all very much the same.
We're all in it together.
This program has just an amazing value.
It's really helped me look at myself as well as see others that are in the same situation that I've been in.
I think I finally recognize my worth.
I can't tell you, you know, how meaningful I think the workshops, the camaraderie, and the discussions, and the writing that we've had have been for me.
The bonding with the other guys has been just as good, if not better, than the riding.
It's like we've almost all known each other for a long time.
11, you know, incredible dudes from all parts of the country, you know, with similar experiences, similar backgrounds, similar affinity for motorcycles.
Learn more about each other and how to deal with the stresses of life.
The depth of that relationship is absolutely amazing to me.
These people now, they'll be brothers for the rest of my life.
This organization is extremely valuable.
We'll always have this, and I'll always be able to connect with these guys that kind of get what it is to be a veteran.
Taking home a lot of gratitude.
One of the best weeks of my entire life. Thank everybody for participating.
I just can't say thank you enough.
I think you've saved a lot of lives.
I enlisted, ready to serve, ready to defend, but my fight has just begun.
Help this hero win his fight. Visit hopeforthewarriors.org
today. My name
today.
Is Kirk Bauer. I'm Executive Director of Disabled Sports USA.
I was in the infantry in the Delta region.
It was an explosion. It flipped me over. I could tell I'd been hit bad. I spent 6 months in the hospital. Some veterans came to me. They had actually just begun an organization of disabled Vietnam vets and 10th Mountain Division World War II vets. When someone becomes disabled, the process of getting back into life, to regaining your confidence, to regaining your hope, to being a full participant in society is not an easy one. It's not a straight line. It's a struggle. It's a day-to-day struggle. I can't think of a better example than the young warrior that I went up Kilimanjaro with, Neil Duncan. He had been blown up in the highlands of Afghanistan. His two legs were off. He was breathing through a tube in his neck. You talk about a guy who's on the edge of death, who was just about finished. Neil Duncan was that man. When he finally got out of the hospital, we got him involved in sports. In his exuberance, Neil decided he was going to climb Kilimanjaro, and he just joined up with a group that didn't know anything about disabilities. They moved him too fast. He got up to 16,000 feet and couldn't make it any further. He was defeated. He had to come back. He said it was the hardest decision he ever made. He came to me and said, Kirk, I have failed, and I can't live with myself. I know I can do the mountain, but we have to do it right. Will Disabled Sports USA help me?
Mind strong, body strong, try to find equilibrium.
Sometimes it's two steps forward, one step back. You are going to face situations where you're going to be disappointed or discouraged or defeated. Don't let that stop you. Pick yourself back up and go on. And Neil made it to the top.
We'll be right back. You're listening to the best station that plays today's hits and today's connections to help our military transition to civilian life. Keep watching. Due to copyright laws, we cannot play via Twitch, YouTube, Facebook, or Twitter. If you'd like to listen to our music, feel free to download our MBR app. You can find the app at our website, which is www.mbrradio.us. That's www.mikebravoradio.us. Or you can hit us up iTunes and Android Store. Keep listening. We will be right back. I promise.
Get your phones ready. The H-Train Show wants to hear from you at 720-619-0627. Best caller text of the night wins a prize from the H-Train Show at 720-619-0627. MBR and the H-Train Show giving veterans a voice.
Hey, hey, hey! We're going to start this show off with a bang. You're listening to the show that highlights all the nonprofit programs out there beyond the VA. You're listening to the Ace Train Show, and we're going to hit this because it's that time.
Today's interview of the week is brought to you by Colorado Moto Service. We make motorcycles happy, and they tend to make their owners even happier.
And we want to welcome Doc to the show. Welcome!
Oh, look at that. That must be nice.
What, you can't drink on the college campus? I don't understand.
Exactly. We've been busted so many times. If we get caught one more time, we're getting kicked out.
Yeah.
And by No, you're good. We're not.
Oh, no. They're not going to come and kick me out. I'm in a hotel.
My wife won't let me buy a food truck because I can turn a food truck into a studio.
That's a genius. I don't say this to you very often. That is a genius idea.
That is
mobile broadcasting.
Yeah.
That would be great.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Well, we need to talk about this. We should talk.
Yeah, tacos, tequila.
Who gets it? Ladies and gentlemen, we are. Is it right to use your real name? Or just go stick with Doc?
Yeah, okay.
So I like
you can use it.
Cajon, am I saying that right? Look at him. He's finishing his drink. This is my kind of interview right here. So from Danger Close Golf, it's nice to have you on the show. Thank you for being a part of the H-Train Show. We really appreciate you taking some time out of your busy schedule tonight to be a part of the show, man.
Can you hear us okay?
Yeah, thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Anytime. Literally anytime. Yeah, I think so.
I think he has a delay on his connection.
I think maybe. He's been drinking, and that's why. That's what it is. And I think I'm jealous.
Yeah.
So this is not fair. So let's start at the beginning. So let's start. I mean, you and I haven't really talked all that much. Tell us, start your military career. What branch of service were you? What brought you into the military? That kind of stuff.
So I was Air Force, and first foremost, I'm working with really terrible hotel internet, so I'm sorry. I was Air Force for about 8 years, and ended up in special operations as a medic for the last 3 years of my career, which was a blast, a good time. Love being a medic, and continue to do a little bit of that. I teach for Dark Angel Medical now, as well as doing some government work, working for Uncle Sugar. And then obviously Danger Close. So
very cool. We're going to have Dark Angel on in, I think next month or something like that. I think they're coming on. So yeah, that's awesome to hear. Glad to hear.
Maybe that hotel internet must be cricket.
He's got a little phone connected to, he's dialing up from. If it makes you feel any better, we're on college internet. So yeah, ours isn't all that great either. So we get you, man. Hey, so tell us about Danger
Close
Golf. How did that come to be?
Yeah, so Danger Close came to be basically travel for work a lot, and I was out working or just hanging out with buddies, and we couldn't figure out what to do with some of our time off, and we were just bored, and went and got some golf clubs from Played Against Sports, and we were hitting the ball around, and we realized that we were doing the same thing that we do at a bar, or whether it was smoking cigars and drinking and just hanging out, just razzing each other, and they were all vets. Did I lose you?
No, we're still here. We got you. If you got us, you're not moving, which is super cool. You're all right. Keep talking.
All right. Internet. But yeah, so they were all vets, and we just kept. Hey, so we kept playing golf with each other and giving each other a hard time. Cool. I could try on my phone. This is dumb.
if you're more than welcome to give us a
But yeah, so we
can just have them call in voice call.
Yeah
if, video. If you have your cell phone with you and you want to click that same link on your cell phone, go ahead. Take a break, man.
Yeah, let's do that. This internet's so bad, it's not worth it.
Yeah, give us a call back. We'll wait for you.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm on. All right.
See you in a minute.
Sounds good.
Okay. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
That's awesome, dude.
His connection's cricket, man.
So that's awesome, dude. You are not a professional golfer, but you did play on a team. How did you golfed a lot, right?
I didn't play on a team. All I did was I went to like a lot of golf events and like golf, you know. Shotgun, like nonprofit shotgun. Fundraiser.
What's shotgun?
Yeah, so a shotgun start is where everybody shoots out at the same time. One's on 8, one's on 7, one's on 6, you know, every hole.
Not even close to what I was hoping it was.
Yeah.
Anyway, keep talking.
And that's what they call a shotgun start. As soon as they shoot the shotgun, then everybody starts.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That sounds cool.
That's usually, you know, so.
But other than the times that you and I go to the driving range, you don't.
Oh, no. I was never on a competitive team or anything that. No. Are you kidding me? You haven't seen me golf yet.
Yeah, we did the driving range that one day.
Yeah, that's a driving range.
But that's all I've ever done. I don't know anything different.
Oh, okay. Well.
I've had one golf lesson, dude.
I lose lots of balls, like. I quit going to the golf place because the par 3 course is right next to the highway. Mm-hmm. I swear to God, I hit one of those cars on the highway.
That's
because I sliced it to the left.
That's what I'm looking for. That's what I want to do. We're on the same page there. I'd like to get on the I-25 overpass and start driving balls.
That'd be awesome. Oh, note to self. I don't know how many of you guys are friends of mine. But I learned the hard way this weekend that going to Barnes & Noble and mimicking the author's signature in the book, it doesn't bring out happiness, at least.
Say what now? What are you doing?
I was at Barnes & Noble. I got kicked out.
I feel like you need an escort everywhere you go. Oh, is he back?
Let's bring Doc back.
Let's bring Doc back.
Let's definitely bring him.
Yeah, exactly. Over here with
police officers listening to this show. Can you hear us now?
Is it good?
Perfect. Perfect.
Well, we're glad you're back. Yeah. All right, so Doc from Danger Close Golf was telling us, where did Danger Close Golf start? And you were talking about golfing with your friends.
I'm going to murder this internet.
That's you're good now. You're good now.
I am having way too much fun with this interview. I'm having a really good time. Can you hear us?
I know,
okay,
but I can't even hear. Occasionally, yeah.
Hey, it's better than our listeners, man. If you can hear me, you're doing better than our listeners are.
Fair enough. So I think you asked how we came about. So just a bunch of vets golfing, and none of us were good, and we're still not good. So we were just knocking balls around, and I noticed that number one, the only time we're really like saying nice things is in golf. You know, I thought that was kind of an interesting thing about golf and fishing too, where you're actually complimenting each other, like, oh, that was a good hit or nice catch for fish or what have you. And
we
go, yeah. Well, I mean, yeah. There's plenty of razzing. But like when they actually do something right, when you actually do something right, you're like, oh, okay, nice work, because I couldn't do that if I tried. So we all we were playing, and I went online and I was looking, and I'm like, I just wanted a veteran like golf shirt because polos look like ass on me right from the get go. So I was like, well, I'm gonna go find a polo. And the only polos I saw was like big, like giant Air Force polo, or like the big Army, like the Army of One logo, and they were all just terrible. Like basically the BX special, not to disparage the BX, because I'd like to put our stuff in there at some point. But
love our PXs and BXs. You're doing great, APs.
Yes, please put a Dark Angel or Close in there.
Do you have any apparel at like the Bass Pro Shop yet?
No. So, you know, we're still super, super, super new. We started before the pandemic, and that really put a hamper in on people going outside and playing golf in most states, because lame.
The shirt and the stickers that you sent to me, I brought them here into the studio and gave out all the stickers to everybody here on the staff. And dude, everybody loves those graphics. That stuff is super cool, man. And thanks for the shirt, by the way. Love that too. But yeah, everybody, you have the coolest stickers in golf.
Yeah. Well, I mean, so like you look at the stickers, our main goal is to do like veteran related stuff that's not like in your face overt, where it's just ridiculous. So like I'm wearing, you know, my golf shirt here, but it from far away, you're like, what is that? That's just a golfer. And then you look closer and you're like, oh, he's got nods and a rifle. And so it's just kind of that's kind of what we're going with a lot of our stuff. And you know, because the whole company is veteran owned, and then our artist is a veteran tattoo artist, so he does all our art, which is nice. I have to bribe him with Cheez-Its and stuff. it works out. But yeah, so as a veteran owned company, you know, I didn't want us to be called veteran owned without donating part of our profits to veteran charities, which is huge. A little bit of everything. We're flying down this weekend for the Folds of Honor golf tournament in Panama City. So we're doing a couple holes down there for their charity. Prior to that, we did Idaho Backcountry Veterans. Did an elk hunt and a fishing tournament for them, which is a really cool charity if you're out in Idaho. They take disabled vets, kind of like the video that ran before, taking dudes out hiking, hunting, whatever. So they're real solid. And then just some of the first responder charities.
Honestly, we're so new that we I haven't taken a paycheck from the company yet. It's all going to either charities or back end to developing stuff. So,
well, the stuff you're developing is awesome. People really like it. First of all, that graphic that you shared with us today, that thing is awesome. He's pouring himself another one.
Lucky.
There is no justice in this world.
Lucky.
This is unfair. Why am I held like this, but he gets to party like a rock star? Why do you hate me?
I don't hate you.
You don't have to lie.
I don't hate you. I got nothing but love for you.
First of all, that graphic is outstanding. And it started, I don't know if you followed some of the comments on Facebook and Instagram and stuff like that, but you might have started something. People are like, hey, golfing under nods, that sounds like an awesome idea. Let's put that together. And I'm like, that's a horrible idea, having worn a nods before. Yeah. Let's not do that.
Yes.
I feel myself getting hit with golf balls a lot if that happens.
Yeah, so speaking a little bit from experience here, if you throw an IR chem light on someone and then the other teams are out there, what it ends up being, you'd think that everyone's playing golf with nods and having a great time, but it ends up being like who can hit the chem light in the distance.
That sounds like an awesome. Actually, I think MBR could probably get behind something like that. We're, as you may have heard in the earlier segment, we're fans of violence here in the show. So I like what you're doing here.
Yeah, so what's, the old get punched in the mouth thing. Like, hey, take a golf ball to the face.
See, this guy gets it. He needs a radio show. Yeah. We need to talk to him about this. So what's on the horizon for Danger Close Golf? What do you guys got next in the shoe? I saw you got some stuff going on with fishing and stuff like that.
Yeah, so just today, actually, we went ahead and released a bunch of our fishing designs on the website. So we got some cool ones. Got like a little Top Gun themed. If you guys ever played like the Super Nintendo Top Gun, where no one could land on the aircraft carrier.
yes.
So we got like a trout going after a fit fly, sailfish, you know, yelling fixed bayonets because he's got his big old sword, obviously. But launching into that, and we'll have like the actual like fancy Columbia type fishing shirts here soon, and kind of branching out into that. So that way, when I'm down in Florida, which is where I'm moving here soon, I can go fishing under the guise of advertising.
I like it. I like it a lot. I like it a whole lot. I'm a big fan of things like this because I believe that our generation of veterans, our therapy is to get out and do these things. If you look at the previous generations of veterans, you know, post-Vietnam, things like that, those guys, they didn't have organizations like yours. They didn't have things like we're a not-for-profit. You know, there's nobody asking these veterans to come on and create a radio show or create a golf company. Right. I really think you're doing really good things. We're big advocates for lowering that number from 22 a day to zero. And I think organizations like yours are a huge part of doing that. And so I really like what you guys are doing.
Yeah, I'm hoping that with, our designs and, we're a for-profit, but we're donating as much money as we can to support the charities that are getting people out or helping people, whether it's, SOCAF or what have you. The one thing that I learned about fishing, growing up in Montana is that it's therapeutic. And I didn't think that golf would be therapeutic because most of the time I'm threatening to break my clubs on a tree. but, it's the one good hit or, just being out with your buddies. Like I found a couple times where I was just super stressed out as a vet I went and sat down on a bench and just let some people roll past me. And I'm just sitting there in nature and it's, these green spaces, golf courses are all over cities and you don't have to be good at golf. You could just go out and chill. And that was really helpful. And then bringing buddies along with me. And so between that and fishing, that's kind of our goal, farther horizons, looking at doing disc golf too, but just giving people who enjoy these activities, like some clothing and then a reason to go out and have beers with your buddies.
One of our producers,
or not drink, I don't care.
Is a big disc. One of our producers here is a big disc golf guy. He's talking about going pro, isn't he?
He does tournaments.
He does tournaments and gets money.
Yeah,
hippie Birkenstock wearing tie dye hippie bullshit, man. Whatever, dude. What do you call it? I forgot what my point was.
You got so mad about disc golf.
I
over
do,
here.
Man. I just don't. He drives me nuts.
You need a hug?
Are you giving him out?
I am.
All right, man. Thanks, dude. This is why I keep you around, bud. Yeah. See, you're the best co-host I've ever had. So you got a whole bunch of veterans lists all over the world that are listening to you right now. So the power of internet radio is my favorite thing. If a veteran's wanting to get into this, into golf and get started, we're big fans of the Veteran Golfing Association. We love Common Grounds Golf Course here in the Denver metro area. How is a veteran going to, can they get into golf? I mean, like you said, you just go to Play It Against Sports, grab yourself a pair of clubs and start whacking balls or what?
Yeah. I mean, so you have, you know, VGA, you have Folds of Honor, and just getting involved with those veteran organizations that can get you out onto the course. But truth be told, all I did is I went to the local thrift shop and I bought the cheapest golf clubs I could. And I just started going out there and then realized I was absolutely terrible and took some tips from buddies. But, you know, it seems kind of like one of those gatekeeping, like price sport things. But there's what my dad calls pasture pool, you know, all over the country. And that's just a flat golf course that a farmer turned into, you know, a golf course. And there's just really easy to get out there. It's just as easy for fishing, you know. And even if you're terrible, just go do it. I think you'll like it. And you don't got to wear like the ridiculous high socks or like a floppy hat or anything like that.
But what if you want to wear that?
Oh, no, that's perfectly okay. I have yet to see it on a golf course. And I know that if I see it, I'm going to go be friends with that guy. Like we're going to pair up.
Well, and that's I when I picture veterans golfing, I picture Ranger panties and cutoff t-shirts and, you know, things like that. And I can't imagine that we are well accepted in the golfing community, because I see those are like bankers and investment guys and, you know, corporates and blah, 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 blah. And, you know, here we walk out with a pair of, you know, USASOC Ranger shorts on. And yeah.
Yeah, you got to find – if you're going to go just full send, you got to find the right place. We did our first annual golf tournament 2 years ago. We haven't had another annual, so that's convenient. So maybe it was first and last. But, yeah, the guys are out there. We had Ranger panties. We had dudes in kilts, and they were wearing them full Scottish. And something about
old Scottish. Did you guys pick up what that was?
That means no underwear.
There you go. You get see, intern gets it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, something about, you know, just the innate male nature. You see a skirt and, you know, your buddy goes to squat down to grab his ball and you're like, oh no, I've done it again. And there's three balls instead of just the one golf ball.
I'm interested. I'm absolutely interested. Hey, man, hold on 1 second. We're going to push a button real quick. Hold on.
Today's Time to Shine is brought to you by Law Offices of Diane Sawaya. Smart, aggressive, compassionate. It's more than a slogan. It's our mission.
This is your time to shine, baby. It's your time to shine.
I really need to redo that.
No, man. We cannot change that. So if you didn't know, our intern is actually part of a boy band. He's got the dance moves.
Oh, okay.
That's him singing that right there. That's his own song. It's original.
You wrote that's himself. What my wife said when I bought these white pants.
Why are you wearing? Well, anyway, so Doc, this is your time to shine. We may have missed a question. We may have glossed over something you wanted to talk about. We may have skipped over something. Take the next. Well, now you have 90 seconds. Take the next 90 seconds and talk about whatever you want in relation to the veteran community, Danger Close Golf, where you're going, your sponsors. Pimp all your social media stuff, whatever you want. Go.
Yeah, deal. All right. Hey, so Danger Close Golf. We just launched Danger Close Fishing. Just check us out. You know, even if you don't golf or you don't fish, which is weird that you don't do either, you should fix that. Just take a look at our website. Christmas is coming up, and we've all got those older veteran folks. You know, if there's anything you like, then buy it or just bookmark it and keep checking, because we're constantly coming out with new stuff. We're not the super limited veteran companies where we launch something and then take it away forever. It's just there. So if you're thinking about it, get it. And just know that, you know, a portion of that's going to charity and the rest of it is going to my my drinking habits, and that's important too.
We are advocates of all of those things. So yeah, absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, we've been talking to Doc Mike Rahone from Danger Close Golf and Danger Close Fishing. I can't thank you enough for being a part of the H-Train show and really from taking time out of your busy schedule and your day to be a part of this. And so thanks a lot, man. Really appreciate it.
Yeah. Cheers. Thanks for having me.
To you as well. Have a great night, man.
All right.
That was kind of funny. That was actually a really good interview. Yeah. Other than our technological.
All right. Got internet problems.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's that Dear Alley.
Please welcome to the stage, Dear Alley.
I'm only going to say this one time, so listen up. I'm here to educate. I'm here to educate you guys because I didn't have any help when I got out of the service.
Sir, do you understand the function of quotation mark? Do you understand that I was not the one that said that? I was merely...
A VSO is a Veteran Service Officers. And what we do is we help you file claims. We help you with your education benefits. We help you with your dependent stuff. Everything related to service and what you need to be successful during your transition, that's what a VSO does.
Dear Alley is sponsored by Gertie Enterprises.
What's up?
What's up? Hi, guys.
How the heck are you?
I'm good.
That's not convincing.
No, I'm not good, you guys. Oh,
what's up?
Gosh.
Talk to us. I mean, hey, air it on the radio. What's up?
I am not going to air my dirty laundry on the radio, but I will say the week leading up to Veterans Day is always stressful for me. So,
well, if you don't want to air your dirty laundry, you can air the dirty tapes.
What?
There are no tapes. There are no tapes.
Back when dirty tapes were a thing.
You have to pay for OnlyFans.com.
Yeah, exactly.
This shit ain't free.
Right. Veterans Day is coming up.
Yes. And my guest speaker doesn't even know what state he's going to.
Yeah. I wish you could be out there on smoke breaks when we're out there. Oh, my God. It's funny.
So he is going to Boston, Massachusetts. But you're not staying in Boston. You're staying in Foxborough because that's where your host works.
I just know Southwest takes me one place and then somebody comes and picks me up, or they give me the address and I Uber.
Yeah.
So I have no sense of direction whatsoever at all. That's the reason why I didn't last very long in
Atlanta
bikers group. Because I'm not very good at directions at all.
So you're not speaking to little children. So I have a huge event. So Pat Patriot, the Patriot cheerleaders are coming.
You're talking to cheerleaders? How do I get to go to the auto shop and you
No, we got the cheerleaders coming. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We got Pat Patriot. We got the cheerleaders. We got Partners in Patriotism coming. We got some members of the craft group. We have the 215th Army Band. We got Sarcastic Swine grilling and smoking on site. We got banjo. Like, it's a big deal, you guys. We got all branches of the service recruiters there. Yeah, it's a big thing. And then after the ceremony, we're all going to the cafeteria where Sarcastic Swine will be catering. Tons of food. We do have to kind of chew and screw because then we have to go down to the Sage School and they're a private, like, buku bucks, like, and you're talking to 12 to 14 year olds, so nothing younger than 12, but the little kids are lining the street in, like, the what's it called, the oh gosh, the parking lot. And so when veterans drive up, they're going to have little flags, right? But the flags. So hopefully nobody in Foxborough is listening to this. I actually ran out of little waving flags. So we're actually going to be waving graveside flags. We're just not going to tell the kids they're graveside flags. So they're all going to be waving, yay, thank you for your service, and making signs and stuff. And then the 215th is coming out and they're playing for us. And they always do such a fantastic job. Chief Stephen Martins is just amazing human being.
What's changed with your parole officer? You're allowed within 50 feet of a school now.
Oh, please don't do that to me.
The same thing was said this weekend to my wife. She literally flipped out. What are you talking about, Willis?
And now I know why I'm not invited, because you're going to talk to 14-year-olds about not bullying like handicapped people. And that's why I'm not allowed to come, because I would trip you down a flight of stairs.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Are you bringing the dog? You cannot bring the dog, right? Because he's blind.
Yeah, the dog's blind.
Oh, blind. I thought you said blind.
That stuff was hilarious. I know I'm going to go to hell for it, but I told. So Sunday, my wife had to go to my in-laws. And then when she went to my in-laws, before she left, she's like, hey, I want to take Barrett so that he can see the kids and stuff. And I'm like, okay.
See the kids?
Yeah. So I open the door for Barrett. Here he is. Boom. Hits his head right on the door because he can't see.
That poor dog.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's blind.
You're crippled. He's blind. I can't imagine you two walking down the street together.
He's retired.
Yeah. So, Allie, what else has your Veterans Day got going on as you're leading up to the Veterans Day? Obviously, as a VSO, that's got to be kind of a challenge right about now.
Yeah. So we also give away turkeys. I made about 150 phone calls today, which is why, like, I'm just, oh, gosh. So 150 phone calls, giving away turkeys. And then there's a group in town. Shame on me. I don't know who does it, but they make homemade whoopie pies. Oh. So that goes like whoopie pies. You guys know what that is, right?
I do, but I want to hear you say
it. Whoopie. So, and they're delicious. So it goes, and then there's squash and there's stuffing. There's a whole big thing. The football team comes out and we deliver it to each address that signed up for a turkey. It's a big to-do, and then football goes and plays Mansfield, but I don't play football. So that's that. I mean, it's a lot. It's a lot of work. I still have to go buy drinks, and I have to make sure the tables are set up, and the school is open, and
Boss lady, you're a veteran. Veterans Day is supposed to be your day to rein it all in.
No. I wish. No, and I can't hang out with anybody on Veterans Day because all my colleagues have to work on Veterans Day too. So it's like, oh, how was your Veterans Day? Hey, do you want, and by the time everything is said and done, it's like 7-8 o'clock at night. We're like, hey, you guys want to hang out? We're all so tired. We're also tired from like meet and greeting and smile and shaking babies and kissing hands. We're tired. So
you've done that.
Yeah, recently, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you're going to do it again.
Okay.
And then, oh, but when I pick you up, so listen, so the Marine Corps birthday is on the 10th, right? Everybody knows this. So I get invited every year because I take such good care of my Marines and they love me. So we were invited. Well, I was invited. And I say, listen, I got a special guest. I can't, you know, just leave him. He's a Paralympian, you know, and they're like, oh, yeah, yeah, he'll be our guest. And I'm like, okay, he's Army. We're going to be there. And he's like,
I'm going to get beat up.
No, you stick with me. It's fine. They love me there. So
I had to make sure that you were.
So it is completely up to you. We can rest for a little while. So if you want to rest, go to the hotel.
No, he'll be fine.
We'll go. Okay, we'll go straight.
A lot of burger and all that.
We don't have. Yeah, so I'll drop you off at the hotel so you can drop off your stuff. You can poop and shower and do all that stuff you need to do.
Hey, just don't make fun of me if I'm running back and forth in your driveway because I got to get my steps in.
8 miles a day.
If you don't make fun of him, I'll be disappointed.
I am absolutely going to make fun of him. You must not know me.
Turn it into a TikTok.
So you could just walk up and down the stairs because what happens is they rent the top floor of Bar Louie's. And last year, well, it was COVID, I was invited and I went and I didn't have a Veterans Day ceremony because governor said you couldn't have one. So I was a good girl and I didn't have one. So I drank way too many gin and tonics and way too many shots of whiskey. And it was the priest. It was Father Matt. Thanks, Father Matt, he's a priest, Catholic priest, and he's a Marine. He's actually the state police chaplain. And he kept feeding me shots all night. And then the next day, I was like, oh, my God, thank God I don't have an event because I wouldn't make it. It was awful. Dude, so we're only staying for a drink or two. We're showing face, and then I'll take you back to the hotel. I will pick you up 9 o'clock in the morning on Veterans Day.
All right.
It's amazing the time.
So in other words, she's going to drop me off at the hotel and then she's going to go back and she's going to drink.
Absolutely. I'm going to Uber home. Yes, sir.
Is it not amazing how we recover when we were in the military, had a couple of drinks versus now? My wife makes fun of me all the time now.
It's true. Like, I used to drink with the best of them. Like, and then, you know, it'd be 2-3 in the morning. We're like, oh, crap, PT's in a couple hours. We go home, you know, we'd shower, drink coffee, put on our PT uniform, put on our belt, and go to formation. I can't do that.
Well, we can still do the drinking part. It's the next day.
It's the next day. And I never thought I would get there. I would, and I'm like younger than you guys. And so I don't know how you guys do it. It was bad. It was really bad. It literally took me all day to recover.
Yeah. Same. My daughter's graduation party, exact same thing. I was on the couch till 5 o'clock the next day.
Yeah.
I was like, I just throw McDonald's at my face and whatever.
Oh, it's so bad. So we're only staying for like 2 or 3 drinks and then we're going to get out of there. But I did want to talk about, I actually had something to talk about, believe it or not. So let's talk about the difference between welfare and compensation. Okay, veterans benefits, for those of you listening, you're like, I don't need that, I'm not disabled. So one, the percentage that the VA assigns you is not the level of function. So if you're 50% disabled through the VA, that does not mean that only 50% of you still works. It is just for math purposes. It is just so the VA knows how to pay you. Okay, then compensation is not welfare. Welfare, you don't really do anything. You don't just sign it. I can't work. Oh, welfare. Compensation.
Is she okay?
Listen, it's been a long day. But compensation is for a job done. You've already, and this is tea. I don't know.
Giggling.
You guys, it's been a long day. No, I'm sitting here eating my cheese like a good little Portuguese girl, drinking my tea. So compensation, you guys know. Okay, so I made a video today on TikTok. What is a hill you're willing to die on 1,000% of the time? Well, this is it. Veterans benefits, it is not welfare. It is compensation, you guys. You're being compensated for a job you've already done, for an injury sustained, for mental stress, for whatever the case may be, whatever happened to you while you are on active duty. This is the way the government is repaying you, I guess. It's compensation for a job done. It is not welfare. Your percentage of disability does not define you. You're 30%, you're 80%, you're 100%. It does not mean level of function. It is for VA math purposes only. So you guys need to stop thinking that. Stop thinking like, oh, I don't want to be 50%, 60% disabled. You're not. You can still walk up the stairs. You can still function. You can still go get yourself a job. It is for math purposes only, guys.
Well, and VA math is the weirdest thing I've ever
seen. There's
no calculator where it makes sense. Like, if you get, because 10% and 10% does not equal 20%.
Does not. Nope. So what the VA does is they'll take your highest rated percentage, so like 50%, and then they'll times it by something, they'll divide it by something, then they'll take the next lowest, and then they'll times that and then divide that. Basically, everything has to be divisible by 10. So if you're like 93%, you're only going to get paid 90, because that second number, if it's 4 and below, they're going to round down. If it's 5 and up, they're going to round up. So if you're 97%, you're going to round up to 100. If you're 26%, you're going to be 30%. So it's only divisible by 10. So you can't be 22%. You're 20%.
No sense at all. I will never forget getting that envelope and opening it up. And my wife and I were reading this envelope, you know, the contents of this envelope. And you're like, I think I'm 346% disabled. I'm not really sure what happened here.
Right. So 1+1 math. Yes, that's possible. But VA math, it's only up to 100, because you are only 100% of a person. You can't be 110% of a person. You're only 100, right? That's goal. That's max. 100% of a human being. That's you. And then they'll reduce by that.
Well, he gives 110% on this show every month.
Well, he gives it, but that doesn't mean he's 110% of a person.
No argument here. I'd barely give him 10.
How's your speech coming along?
Wait, he has to write a speech?
Oh, yes!
She's asked this every Monday for the last 3 months.
I know.
She still doesn't even know he's going to Boston. You think he has a speech?
I can send you the summary brief of my life and stuff, but speech wise,
sent me your bio.
I've done it so many times. I speak from the heart, and I don't sit there and go, I don't do that.
You're making me nervous. If you don't have it on paper, you're making me nervous. I've read your bio.
I got it on paper. I can send it to you right now.
And it's gonna be live. Like it's gonna be broadcast live.
And you'll record it and send it to me. so that we can have.
Yes. You can watch Foxborough Cable Access. I will text you. Actually, I don't even have your number, so you text me. I'll send you the link.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
Gosh, Joel, you make me so nervous.
I don't know why you're nervous.
He's radio.
I got this.
He talks for a living.
I'm sending this to you now.
He'll do fine. I've seen it. I've seen his tap dance. He'll do fine.
And there's no video, like, just so you know, there's no, because we're not at the high school, we're at the middle school, so there's no, like, video projection. Well,
and whenever he stumbles, all he does is start, like, doing the Jerry Seinfeld, how about that airplane food, huh?
I'm just going to cancel Veterans Day.
So awesome. She's going to forget to pick you up at the airport, bro.
I know, right?
So I want to address this comment that came in about hopefully, and I don't know if this person's being funny, if this person doesn't know me, but one, if you're a veteran, I'm going to help you. So whether you got hurt in basic training or not is, one, that's not my problem. It's your problem. It's not my role to judge. If you are considered a veteran, I will absolutely help you get your whatever you deserve. Not everybody warrants 100%. So if you get out of basic, one, if you don't finish basic, odds are you're not going to get 100%. Unless your injury was so severe that you had to be medically discharged right then and there, then you're going to get what you deserve. But no, Mr. Bernie, I do not help random non-veterans get their 100%.
See, now we like to hear that. We like your attitude, Allie, we have to go because we have to go to the whole tribute.
I sent you my speech summary, but I tell you, a lot more comes out.
Please keep me in the loop. Please keep me on this.
I'm gonna put my phone number in the chat, in the private chat, not the chat where everybody can see.
I got your phone number.
I'll get it.
Don't you worry.
Okay.
I got your number. Right.
Allie, have a great Veterans Day, and thank you. Thank you. Take care of homeboy here. We need him back on Monday.
Like in one piece?
I didn't say that. The rest is up to you. Hey, have a great Veterans Day.
Yeah,
I appreciate you guys very, very much. I'll see you Wednesday. Yay! Bye, boys. Bye.
See ya.
If he was really good at his job and he really wanted to be bad, he would, after I said that, he'd start playing "Girls Just Wanna Have Fun" song.
We don't have that.
But
good
luckily,
of technology.
Luckily, I'm glad he's not that good just yet. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is that time. It is tribute to the troops.
This is an MBR moment of heroism.
Sir, I don't know how to tell the story.
Well, you got to, Joe. You tell the American people what these men did here. You tell them how my troopers died.
Military Broadcast Radio proudly salutes U.S. Army Major Thomas Drew Davidson. Drew was born in Leesburg, Tennessee on November the 7th, 1941. He married his high school sweetheart Carolyn in 1966, and he attended the Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University before joining the United States Army. Major Davidson served three tours in the Vietnam conflict, where he went missing in action for a week. He was a decorated veteran, earning the Distinguished Service Cross, Distinguished Flying Cross, 2 Purple Hearts, 34 Air Medals, and a significant number of other military service awards. He was inducted into the Officer Candidate School Hall of Fame at the National Infantry Museum at Fort Benning, Georgia in 2017. He retired from the Army in 1982. Major Thomas Drew Davidson, age 79, a resident of Franklin, Tennessee, passed away on November the 5th, 2021, after a long battle with Parkinson's disease. On behalf of Military Broadcast Radio and a grateful nation, thank you for your service. Until Valhalla, brother.
Prepare.
taking care of those who took care of us. From the shores of Normandy to the black volcanic sands of Iwo Jima, the Best Defense Foundation ensures that any World War II veteran who wants a measure of closure or the recognition he so richly deserves has an opportunity to return to his battlefield. Closure, camaraderie, commendation. Combat Flip-Flops is proud to partner with the Best Defense Foundation to help these heroes return to their battlefield, be recognized for their service, and inspire the next generations toward a lifetime of service to their nation and to the world. Learn more at combatflipflops.com/Best Defense Foundation.
Hey, it's Rob with the Colorado State leader for Mission 22, practicing social distancing today out on the road. I understand for a lot of us that with no gym being open, no jujitsu going on, I know it's a challenging time right now for a lot of folks. You're looking for that community, you're looking for something. Reach out, you know the number, 303-301-5052. You can call that number anytime, I will answer. I know a lot of people are having a hard time. Reach out to your friends. Don't wait till you're in that dark place. Don't wait till you're in that pit. Before you get down there, reach out to your friends. Say, hey, let's talk. Let's go have some social distancing together. Cool? Hey, again, reach out to mission22.com.
Hi, I'm Nico Marcolongo with the Challenge Athletes Foundation. I'm proud to be here with other nonprofits to support our troops get from the front line to the finish line.
You supported us. Now we're supporting you.
Due to copyright laws, we cannot play via Twitch, YouTube, Facebook, or Twitter. If you'd like to listen to our music, feel free to download our MBR app. You can find the app at our website, which is www.mbrradio.us. That's www.mikebravoradio.us. Or you can hit us up iTunes and Android Store. Keep listening. We will be right back. I promise.
We are MBR. Military Broadcast Radio. Every day, 22 veterans lose their battle to post-traumatic stress that is on American soil. That is one veteran every 65 minutes. Help us. Be part of the solution.
Hey everybody, it is H Train, and I am here to tell you a little bit about MBR, the MBR story, and what we are doing. Trust me, I'm very sincere in this whole thing. In 2003, MBR was created by Jim Butler to keep his buddies informed what was going all around the world, all around him. So Joel Hunt, also me, H-Train, took it over in 2018 from an LLC, and I turned it into a nonprofit. The acceptance only took 18 days. That's how much this nonprofit was needed. We used to be just a nonprofit radio station, but now we teach all veterans from all eras, from all over the globe, to be DJs. We show them how to work the equipment. We teach them the computer skills that are needed to conduct a radio show or a podcast, whichever one they desire. After a 9-month commitment, the gear that we teach you on, we go ahead and buy you that same gear and make sure that you're confident and comfortable in your own skin. We accept civilians and military, but you won't find another radio station that does what we do anywhere at all. I guarantee it. Why? Because I'm a retired combat veteran and I have dedicated my life to the station to help our veterans like myself that has the constant battle in their head from war, the what ifs. I listen to music and I'm focused on my show. And that thinking goes away. I do not stop, and my attitude spreads to my DJs. I have found out if you want to be a part of this success, then join me. We will rock our troops for another 10 years. If you're military supported, open those checkbooks and support these veterans, because when we receive donations, 100% goes to the troops, my staff. We do not get paid. Why, you ask? Because we're already retired and compensated through the VA. My program is so successful that even Brandon Stokely, a radio colleague of mine, that I met at 104.3 The Fan has joined me in NBR as a face, as the spokesperson, because he knows, man, we are serious about knocking this 22 out the door. We are not throwing money. We're building our vets to prevent it. Since there's no FM radio station channels overseas for them, we learned about internet radio, and the troops could listen with a VPN number if an American internet IP wasn't established. So what are you waiting for to be a part of this family? We have really grown the last 2 years, and we have nowhere to go but up. And until I die, this radio station will always provide connections and opportunities to all our veterans by giving them a voice. I guarantee it.
Okay, there we go. All right, we're back, ladies and gentlemen. You're listening to the highlights of all the nonprofit programs out there beyond the VA. You're listening to the H Train Show. You know, we've had a really good show today. You know, we talked about the violence that is going around the world, and it's just gotten, yeah, pause it. There you go. Until it gets, yeah, I don't know. The violence is just getting bad, and we talked about the situations, and then we had a great interview with Danger Close Golf, you know. I thought that was awesome. If you missed that interview, be sure to check out the podcast of this show once we get off the air tonight. And then we talked with Allie, and, you know, I think that's the biggest thing, because, you know, when my dad came back from Vietnam, you know, like I said, I didn't even know that he was in the military, you know, and I think he got three types of soldiers. I think he got veterans who they don't think they're worth it to go VA because, you know, they didn't get in combat. I think the other veteran is the veteran that he procrastinates.
He's you know, they'll sit there and complain about the VA, but he's not being proactive. That's the reason why stuff's not happening. And then you have the third guy, you know, kind of like me, that, you know, I just keep my mouth shut, go to the VA, and, you know, that's it. You know, you, those are the three type of veterans that you have. That's what I've noticed. And, but Ali is exactly right. You know, it's not welfare. It's a benefit that you earned when you was in service.
I agree. I agree completely. So, and I have a lot of friends that have been out of the military for quite some time and, you know, did not seek out the VA when they were transitioning out of the military. You know, they just cut to, like the 07, 08 generation.
Right.
When it was hot and heavy and the war was in full effect and whatnot. And did not seek any kind of benefits when they got out of the military, and are now, as they're getting older, like, oh, well, my knees hurt, my hips hurt, my ankles hurt.
Right.
And you, well, hey, man, you have earned a benefit through Department of Veterans Affairs. Mm-hmm. No matter how bad they are, you've earned the benefit.
Right. Exactly.
You're taking this No Shave November thing all the way, huh?
Well, you know, I mean, I would grow hair up here, but it's not a chia pet. It's not working. I've tried everything too. Like, you know, I don't know. It has something to do with the alcohol, but like I had a squad leader that used to tell me that, you know, the difference between shaving with shaving cream and the difference, straight just dry shaving, is your hair doesn't grow as fast if you dry shave.
Do you dry shave?
On my head, yeah, a lot.
Wow.
A lot. I have a Harry's Bic razor. Uh-huh. So I use the shaving cream until it gets dull a little bit, dulled down, because if I try to dry shave, I will cut myself with a Harry's. But Gillette,
Junior went to a place called Scissors and Scotch this past week, not this weekend, but 2 weekends ago.
Okay.
And got a straight razor shave on his head because, you know, he's 20 years old and bald, just like me.
Yeah.
And he said it was the greatest thing he's ever experienced. He loved it.
Oh, I'm going to have to get that number. The last time I had somebody shave my neck and all that stuff, and I looked at it. Now I'm like, wow, I was dumb. But I looked at it as an experience. Mm-hmm. When I was there. It was when I was in Iraq.
Mm-hmm.
One of the Hajis, they were shaving her neck and stuff, and I was just thinking about it. I'm like, you know, this probably isn't a really good idea.
Well, it was super expensive. It was extremely pricey.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Oh, it was like $3 in Iraq.
No, I think he paid like $100 for a shave.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah, it was expensive.
Okay. So, but if it was a great experience.
He said it was.
And you spend $100.
And Roz does it all the time, too.
Okay.
So, yeah, because he's, you know, head shaved, too. I might do it one time December just to see how
it's
try it out. Yeah. But, yeah, so maybe they'll sponsor the show.
Maybe. Maybe. Yes. All right. Well, we got a couple of more minutes. I wanted to reiterate that Saturday, November 13th is the close drive at Bighorns Automotive. If you can make it out there, bring some clothes. Let's make this a big thing, you know? Mm-hmm. And you know, everybody's like spring cleaning and all this other stuff. So I'm sure that you have plenty of covers and so. I found it's never good when you go under the house and you find a Tupperware basket, but I found a Tupperware basket and there's like 30 blankets in there.
Really?
Really?
Hey, do not forget all the stuff for Allie when
yes.
You, and we owe Craig Stackowitz a jacket. No, or is it Reed? We owe Reed a jacket.
Is it Reed?
I think it is.
Well, you can take the jacket and give it to him when he comes and visits you. Right, Reed?
Is he coming to visit me?
Well, I don't know anytime soon. I'm sure he's going to plan on it, though.
Why the hell are you wearing white jeans?
I'm wearing white jeans because it's different. It's style.
No. It's not. No. No, it's
look, like, I already got crap from my wife.
You look like you're
about
in an 80s
it.
Hair band. Does Def Leppard know you're wearing the
it's
pants?
It's time for the 2 minutes.
Five, four, three, two, one. We have ignition. Strap in.
It's the 2 minute warning.
2 minute warning.
What we learned today.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?
Sponsored by Common Ground Golf Course in Colorado. A place for all and all the game
teaches. Yeah, that
wasn't teaches.
Supposed to play. Okay. Anyways, that's a mind mess up.
You pushed the button. How would you mean? Wasn't supposed to
I
play.
Well, I was supposed to stop at the sponsor.
Way to go, intern.
I was 2 hours from long enough.
Nice job.
I cut it off over there. I couldn't reach in time.
Dude has no idea what we're talking about.
Rob, what did you learn today?
What did I learn today? Our VSOs work way too hard for us.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, she looked super stressed. I feel bad for her.
Yeah.
She was, you could tell that she's been working her tail feathers off. Yeah. And somebody that does that for the veteran community, that A, that makes me, I like that there are people that are willing to invest so much of themselves for the veteran community, but we have to take some responsibility as well. And
right.
There's no reason that our friend should be that stressed out over a day that is supposed to be for her.
Right.
And that, yeah, that VSOs work way too hard sometimes. The good ones.
Right. No, I totally agree. I totally agree. Johnny Mike, what did you learn?
Don't take a punch if you are one level down at a Rams football game because you
yeah.
will fall asleep there for hours.
Yeah. Yeah. I'd love to get see the end of that story.
Well, the biggest thing that I learned today was Allie's scared as crap because I don't have something written
Dude,
up.
Dude, have fun with this. You have got to get up there and be like, "You." When you get up to there, you have got to do the whole, I had a speech. Where did it go? Oh, no. Well, I don't know what I'm going to talk about now.
Take us out of here.
That's the show for today, everyone. Thanks for listening. We'll be back next week with an all-new show. And remember, you can listen to us again and again. The podcast, this radio show, will be available as soon as the intern finishes up, right after we go off the air tonight. And remember, we're here for you, not for us, giving our veterans a voice.
See, we do the ending great. I don't know why all the other shows don't do that. Come on, Shooter MacGyver, right?
Shooter
See, this
McGavin.
This is the stuff they should record. Have a great one, everybody. See you next Monday. Bye-bye now.